So I request you to please restrict your questions to the course content, so that I can effectively use your time, and it will be beneficial to other students also. Okay, Nataraj Mahodaya. Next in line is Prema Bhagini, and then Raja Raman Mahodaya. Please be ready to ask your question. Prema Bhagini, you can ask your question. Or Raja Raman Mahodaya, I think you unmuted yourself. Okay.
Hello.
Yes.
You are able to hear me? Sir, Mitra. Somewhere long back, right? Indra also is referred as Mitra, or Surya only is Mitra?
Okay. So in general, in Sanskritam for that matter, the same word can be referred to multiple objects or multiple people based on the context, etc. So there could be a Puranic relevance to it, but as far as I have seen, Mitra Namaha or Mitraha is basically for Surya, but that also could be possible, but need to see the reference and the source where it is present that way.
Oh, dhanyavad.
Sure. Dhanyavad. Prema Bhagini.
Namaste Mahadeya. You said hastam is napumsakalingam, then mastishkam is napumsakam, and udaram is napumsakam. Similarly, netram, I know it is napumsakam. Hastau, again, hasta, I should take it as napumsakam.
No, hasta is a pullinga shabda. Hastaha.
Pullinga.
Hastaha. Okay.
Ridhaya, ridhaya. Then karanaha, padaha is also masculine. Pullingaha.
That is right.
Then netram is napumsakalingam.
Right.
Then dhalani
dalaha or dalaha? Dalani is a dalam is a
napumsakalinga. Then netrani, okay sir. Davedaha, Brahma, all this is definitely pullingaha.
Yes.
Dhanyavadaha.
Astu, dhanyavadaha. So based on our familiarity with the forms of pullinga, strilinga, napumsakalinga, we'll be able to identify it as well. So yeah, okay. Next, if your question is answered, please lower your hands. So Simran Bhagini, next will be in the line is Sandhya Bhagini. And next is Kalyan Mahodaya. Okay. Yes, Simran, you can ask your question.
Namaste, Adhyapak Mahodaya.
Namaste.
Namaste. I have a few questions, but they're very short. Okay. They are about the word. Like you said, Chaturaha in Pullinga, right? Chaturaha.
Chaturaha.
Chatvaraha, Shamita, right. Chatvaraha. But when it came to like the words that were used, Chatur, Mukha, Brahma.
Right.
There so, it was Chatur.
Yeah, I will tell that. So similar to Chaturvimshatihi or anything like that, it is basically a compound word in the example that is being shown for Chatvari. So Chaturvedaha, Chaturmukha Brahma, all these things, or Chaturmukha Simha is basically a compound word. So that's why I gave a different example as well by giving Chatvaraha Putraha, Chatasraha Balikaha, etc. Okay, so that is the way you use it independently.
Yes, sir. So is that actually composed of Chaturaha plus Mukhaha? Is that so?
No, Chatur, basically Chatvari, whatever is there. So Chatur, it will be transformed whenever it becomes a compound word. So that is what it is, not Chatura. Chatura is different. Chaturaha means clever. That is a different word, entirely a different word. And this Chaturmukha is a different one because this is based on four.
All right, sir. And this is again is regarding numbers. Ashta Dishah. So right. Ashta Dishah is it should be Dishaha, na? According
no.
to
me. That's what. No. Disha, basically, it's a different word that we haven't learned. That is the. That is how the words, that is how the forms are. So, Dishaha is a Bahuvachana Rupa.
Okay. What is the main word, sir, for Dishaha?
Dik. Dishaha. Yes.
All right. Last question. This is the 82 and 83. You said Dve Shitihi and Tre Shitihi, but there is Ya. Why did you use A?
Where did I use A? It is Dve Shitihi only. Dvi ashitihi, divya shitihi, tri ashitihi, triya shitihi, yakara. You are asking why yakara is there. So based on a sandhi rule, this is formed. That's how it is.
Sir, please pronounce again once more.
Yeah. Divya shitihi, divya shitihi, त्रियशीति तृ त्रियशीति दैट्स हाउ इट इज प्रोनाउंस्ड
ओके सर द्वय इफ वी ब्रेक इज इट हाफ द हाफ व एंड हाफ य
यस दैट इज राइट
एंड इन त्रया इट्स हाफ त र एंड य ऑल आर हाफ ऑल थ्री
यस
अहम करोति व्हाई डिड यू से सर अहम करोति
I did not say aham karoti. Aham karomi would have I used. I don't know where.
Aham karomi. I'm sorry. Aham karomi. Why did you say?
Why? Because aham is asmat shabda. Whenever we use asmat shabda, we will have to use uttama purusha. Karoti.
No, no. About the pronunciation, sir. Aham. Aham. Ma. Aham.
This, if you refer to our previous classes, I would have told. Whenever there is aham. That is the anuswara is there, right? So let me quickly write it. So this will be the last question for you. Kshamyatam, if there are more questions, please I request you to write an email because most students are also waiting for to get their chance to ask the question. Okay.
Sure.
Yeah. So aham karomi or whatever. So here it is aham. This anuswara is there, followed by any vargiya vyanjana. If it is there, then what will happen? This anuswara will be changed to the fifth letter of that particular varga. That is why aham karomi I said. Similar to aham, if it is there, some other word like aham dadami, then it will become aham dadami. Nakara will come in that case. That's how it is. Okay.
Sir, my only doubt on this was even if they are separate, we will still use the fifth letter to pronounce.
It is depending on whether we tell it together, we give a pause or not. That's it. Aham karomi. If I give a pause, I can say it as aham karomi. And if I want to tell it together, I will say it as aham karomi. That's the only thing.
This clarifies my doubt. Thank you so much, sir.
Dhanyawad. Okay. Sandhya Bhagini.
Namaste, Mahodaya.
Namaste.
Atra, so vane saptami ekavachana iti. तत् सन्दर्भे तत् वने सप्तमी एकवचन भविष्यति अन्यतः वने द्वितीय प्रथम विभक्ति मध्ये अपि वयं वक्तुं शक्नुमः खलु तत् शब्दं वने इति अस्ति चेत् प्रथम विभक्ति द्वितीय विभक्ति इति एव वक्तुं शक्नुमः
द्विवचनम् इति वक्तुं शक्यते तदेव अहं
सन्दर्भम् एव तत् सप्तमी भविष्यति अन्यथा च सन्दर्भोचित अस्तु अस्तु अन्य प्रश्न अस्ति सुभाषितानि वयं कंठस्थीकरणं कुर्मः खलु तत् परीक्षा मध्ये लेखनीयं वा न अस्माकं कृते कंठस्थीकरणीयं वा ज्ञानार्थे
हा उभावपि तत्र परीक्षा कृते अपि तत् अवश्यं तत्र कंठपाठः करणीयः परीक्षा मध्ये
मौखिक परीक्षा न भविष्यति खलु
लेखनं भविष्यति खलु यद्यपि
अत्र
हा
लिखितस्थानानि पूरयेत तत्र भविष्यति वा प्रश्नोत्तर मध्ये भविष्यति वा
उभयत्रापि भवति
किमर्थम् इत्युक्ते गुणिताक्षराणि सम्यक् लेखनीयं खलु तदर्थं पृच्छामि महोदय
सत्यं तदेव तत्र दोषं विना लेखनीयं वर्तते तदर्थम्
अभ्यासं करणार्थे पृच्छामि
अवश्यं
तत्र अनेक षड् दोषाः सन्ति खलु तस्मिन् मध्ये द्वितीयः अपि सप्तमी सारी षष्टि दोषात् अर्थं न ज्ञातवती अहं तन्द्रा
पुनः अहं वदामि आगामि कक्षायाम् अपि पुनः तद् दर्शयित्वा सूचयामि अस्तु
धन्यवादः महोदय
अस्तु कल्याण महोदय यू केन् आस्क् ए क्वेश्चन
यस् सर् नमस्कार
नमस्ते
सर् द सेण्टेन्स् तुभ्यं तानि वस्त्राणि प्रियाणि
राइट
We had identified the cases. Tubhyam was 4.1, Kani 2.3, Vastrani 2.3, and Priyani 2.3.
Right.
But in its answer, you said Vastrani is 1.3. I mean, I'm unable to identify the subject and the verb here. And today you said Priyani is a kind of verb.
No, it's not a verb. It is not a verb. What I mentioned is. One second, let me see if it is there here. I'm not sure. Okay, but anyway, it is not here. Okay, we'll take this. Okay, this also should be fine.
Here it is. It's there, sir. The first two sentences.
Okay, right.
Now,
so see, it is Vastrani Priyani. Vastrani is
this
also
2.3.
No, it is Prathama Bhakti Bahu Achanam only. Similar to this. प्रियम और औड्नम वस्त्रम प्रियम एक्सेट्रा सो वन पॉइंट दिस प्रथमा भक्ति बहुवचनम विच क्लोथ्स डू यू लाइक ओके तुभ्यम कानी वस्त्राणि प्रियाणि ओके सो इवन दिस आल्सो इज basically for vastrani this will be an adjective okay priyani or like it follows the vastrani in that way but priya means basically to like okay so though it is not a tingantam it is a different form in which the kriya the verb the action related thing is embedded in it though it is a namapadam priyam is a namapadam but the action is kind of embedded in this that's what I mentioned okay so it is in prathama bhakti bahuvachanam only
okay sir so next question when we say mama nama kalyana what is the vibhakti of nama here because I got to know that
naman is basically a nakaraanta
so how do we get nam here
nama
this sentence
the forms of that word itself is nama namani namani okay I have written an answer to your email so you can check for
no but more. Nama was not there sir naman
correct so the word that is a pratiparikam okay pratiparikam if you remember that was naman naman is the pratiparikam but the forms of this naman pratiparikam are nama namani namani the first prathama vibhakti ekavachanam form is nama
Okay.
So I've written an email in which I have also given a link to this forms of this nama shabda. So you can refer to that, and probably after that you can ask.
So nama is the subject here, isn't it? Mama nama.
Yes.
Kalyana. Okay.
Yes.
Okay. Now, sir, coming to the avyaya samam, and right. Referring to nasti raga samam dukkham, how the here in this sentence nasti satya samam tapa samam is not the avyaya here I think
no here there that is samam is not avyayam okay samam here it is equivalent that is a samaha sama is a different one that is so sahasakam sardham samam is an avyayam but in that where we are seeing nasti raga samam dukkham okay there it is equal something which is equal to it so that is sama okay so we will see the meaning of subhashitam in the upcoming class so then probably your doubts will be cleared with respect to that
okay sir
sure
thank you dhanyavadaha
astu so I think probably we have exceeded time so dhanyavadaha I have made note of the questions that are there in Q&A chat box if something is very important etc I shall take it up in the next class as you all know so whenever you if you have any questions or anything please write an email to me to raghu.vyoma@gmail.com I'm mostly answering them as early as possible but if there are some mails that I haven't answered or something so please give me time because I would have seen the mail or I would require more time to answer to those questions so I would have not answered it so I shall try to answer them at the earliest So we shall all meet tomorrow for our Q&A session. Dhanyavadaha. Ram Ram Ram.